whenever you present drawback calculations to Customs and Border Protection, you have to have some sort of methodology which is worked out. And very important in here is the methodology which you adopt. You cannot jump back and forth, you must stick to it. But more importantly, you really must be aware of the types of methodologies that exist. So we have three methodologies, and those methodologies can be done under the two ways: abstract method and a schedule method, right? Abstract method, right, just includes summary that were actually used, right? The schedule method, as the name implies, it's a prediction. You say this is the scheduled exportations based on our inventory procedure, and based on the schedule, we think this much of drawback is appropriate. So it goes into this, and some of the some are familiar with taxes, especially with the corporate taxes, it's kind of reminiscent of the accounting method where in Internal Revenue Service is requiring you to adopt either the cash-based method or the accrual method of accounting. So it has its own rules. Let's take a look at the methodologies and see how this stuff is being tested on the exam. So the used-in method talks about the methodology which is based on the actual, whatever as name says, whatever was actually used in it, right? Of course, to use that method, you cannot have any valuable waste. No valuable waste. And this example suggests, right, if you have 10 widgets that were used in production of an export product, right, and one widget was wasted in the production process, for example, you are making a chemical, right, and you have to use number of chemicals, and whenever you mix them up, the chemical reaction takes place. And as a result of the reaction, that particular chemical used disappears, it's no longer around. So that's one of the examples of so-called waste, right? But you still can claim drawback. So in reality, you are exporting really 9 widgets, right? Because one has disappeared. But you can still claim 10 widgets drawback because you actually used 10 widgets. So whatever you're using in, you're claiming as a part of the drawback. The next methodology is appearing in method. So unlike used in method, if one widget disappeared, let's say that during that chemical reaction that widget disappeared, you cannot claim of whatever was used, but you can claim of whatever is inside the product. So using a chemical reaction, if that because of that chemical reaction, that particular chemical is gone, it can no longer be part of this mixture, which is being exported to destroy it, then you are you cannot claim that particular chemical since it disappeared as a part of the drawback. Of course, the limitation, it cannot be used if there are multiple products resulting from the manufacturing process. All right, so used in a less valuable waste method. This is kind of like kind of like use in, except it accounts for waste. So remember the first used in portion, you could not use waste as a part of it. Here you can deduct waste. So let's say you were using using 10 widgets and one widget was wasted, and that one widget cost was the value of it was 0.5. So you deduct 0.5. So the amount of drawback you can get is 9.5. And again, this is just rough abbreviation of what's going on. And of course, those three used in, appearing in, and used in less valuable waste can be used as a part of abstract method or the schedule method. And here is how customs examiners test you on this. So fortunately, I haven't seen customs examiners really testing you on the line item breakdown within the methodology, but they do expect you to know that those accounting methodologies, those bookkeeping methodologies to account for the number of widgets going in and out from the as a part of the drawback claim, kind of did test you on general names. So, which is not approved method for use as a basis of manufacturing drawback claim. And we saw that since we're looking for not approved, we know that approved is used in less valuable waste, abstract or schedule, and appearing in. We saw all that here, schedule, abstract, less variable waste, appearing in, and used in methodologies. So now we know that by process of elimination, we can take this out, take this out, take this out, and take this out, and first in, first out method will the remain the long long standalone item, which of course is correct because it is not approved method as a basis of manufacturing drawback claim. Keep in mind that in the future, please be mindful of manufacturing drawback claim, because later on we will see the accounting methodologies which are approved as a basis of first in first out method, and we will see that as a part of this accounting methodology criteria for certain other drawback types. So first in first out does appear in, but it appears as only applicable to certain types of drawbacks, not to other types of drawbacks. So please be mindful as you learn through this that ability to apply those methodologies really depends on what type of drawback we're talking about, right? So here we're talking about the manufacturing drawback method of claiming where as something is being used as a part of manufacture. Now,